happy Halloween. It's spooky season. Leaves are falling. It's sweater weather. Insert unfunny pumpkin spice joke here. I love Halloween. The costumes, the candy, the decorations, and although nobody should be trick-or-treating this year, that doesn't mean you can't still celebrate. Buy some candy, watch some spooky movies, and most importantly, dress up your pet. This is Solomon, or Sully. He's a sweet, precious baby who I would die for, and also a bastard who steals my food.
Isn't that right?
Here you go. Now, it's not terribly uncommon to dress up your pets on the internet, but I'm going to be taking it one step further. I'm going to be making his costume myself. Now, if every single video I've made up until this point is anything- Don't do that! Hey, don't do that. Now, if every single video I've made up until this point is anything to go off of, I think it's pretty safe to assume that I'm going to be dressing him up as a VeggieTale. But which one? Well, that's easy. The one that's purple and yellow. And one super fellow. That's right. I'm turning my kitty into Larry Boy, Larry's superhero alter ego. So I'm going to be using a pre-existing piece and use that to make a pattern out of. Oh, there he goes. Specifically this little dress, which I know fits him. I think this is going to work pretty nicely. I'm probably also going to make it a little longer than it actually is, too. But with that being said, let's get started.
So I start on making the belt logo by tracing out some foam circles and freehanding the letters. Then I cut them out. Paint them. Some edges. Hot glue everything together. Some paint touch-ups. And then cover the entire thing in Mod Podge. Onto the shirt. I trace the seam lines from the base piece, just a little wider from the actual seam to make sure it's a more comfortable fit. Then I just cut out those pieces. Pin them together. I cut a little slit in the front for the V-neck. Then it's time for the collar. I'm using a white crushed velvet to add a bit of texture, and just tracing along the neckline in the approximate shape I want. Fold in half, and cut. Then cut out a copy. Then trace that shape onto this foam stabilizer, and I cut it out just a little bit smaller than the actual fabric, so it's gonna fit. Then I sew the fabric pieces along the top with right sides facing, turn inside out, stuff the foam inside, and pin directly to the shirt, and sew. Cut out a long strip of velvet that I sew onto the V-neck on one side and flip over, kind of like it's bias tape, but if bias wasn't pre-folded. And then I sew down the other side by hand. Then taking thin strips of yellow that I stretched out until they curled, I sew those directly onto the shirt. I only went with two strips, even though the official design is three, because it's pretty small and I don't want to put them too high up and risk choking my boy. Then I took a long rectangle of this metallic purple knit and sewed that onto the bottom of the shirt. I know Larry Boy's belt is supposed to be black, but I like purple better, and it makes the outfit a lot more cohesive with the helmet. Then I mark out where I want the belt buckle to be and glue it onto the shirt. I put it on the back so it's more visible. And just like that, the shirt is done! For the helmet, I used a shrunken down and slightly modified version of the Kamui Cosplay Supervillain Helmet pattern, which is a free pattern from their website. I cut the pieces out of 2mm foam. Hot glued them together and then made a few minor adjustments. Tracing the finished dome, I drew out the shape for the top of the helmet and cut out two copies of it on 5mm EVA foam. I tried hot gluing them together, but by the time I got glue on the entire piece, one side would have cooled down so much it was no longer sticky, so I took out my heat gun and melted all of the glue evenly and pressed the two pieces together. Then just trimmed them a bit for a smoother edge. Then I glued the top on, and it was time to move on to the plungers. First, I used this shape from my paint palette to mold some foam clay and set those aside to cure. Using Evil Ted Smith's free foam dome pattern, I cut out some pieces of craft foam and glued them together to make two domes. I eventually managed to cut out this wooden dowel. I think I might need to invest in a saw someday. I made some holes in the foam clay pieces. Shortened the dowels because they were too long for my liking. Cut some holes in the helmet. Glued the clay and dowels on. Glued on the domes. Rolled out long tubes of foam clay and attached them around the edge of the plungers and the base of the cured clay, and then let that all to dry for 2 days. Before painting, I primed the surface with a layer of gesso to prevent chipping and cracking. gave the whole thing a layer of purple spray paint off camera, then went over again with a layer of Angelus purple paint for more vibrancy. With a small brush, I applied the yellow accents. Then I mixed a bright pink acrylic with Angela's autumn red to give it a more muted tone. Then covered the whole thing with Mod Podge, and the costume's done.
So, yeah, I think the costume is pretty much done. So that means there's only one thing left to do. Test it out on my boy.
Sully!
Watermelon cat. Yeah, I don't think he likes it.
Oh, he fell off!
Okay, I went back and cut this a little bit shorter, and maybe it'll fit a little better. There's my boy. Ignore my very messy floor. Hi! Oh. Hi. Your shirt's falling off. And that was making a Halloween costume for my cat. It was fun, but I don't think I'll ever do it again because I could buy one and it would look a lot better. But that's the end. I hope you enjoyed it. It's a little bit different, but I kind of just want to be able to do whatever I want. And if I reach 100,000 subscribers, I'll do this again, but in full scale. I'll make a VeggieTales cosplay if I reach 100,000 subscribers. And I feel confident enough saying that now, because it's gonna take me like 5 years to get that many. And then everyone will have forgotten, and I won't actually have to do it. Super suction.